Hey, welcome back. We're going into Grunty's mouth right now. And it is dark and spooky.
Yeah, so here's where we would have, or here's where we did open the desert.
All right. Is that supposed to be lava down there?
You tell me.
It's difficult to say.
Yeah, sorry, the camera doesn't exactly give me a whole lot to pan down on.
Well, I mean, like, I see it, like, kind of bubbling, sort of. It's so weird.
Think of it as a cheap cop-out to lava.
Sure. Lava effects on the N64. Am I right?
Hey, you do what you can.
Well, I don't know. You know, when I think about it, they had some fantastic lava effects on Conker's Bad Fur Day. I mean, you had a lava, like, air surfing race thing, too.
Right.
That was annoying. Did not enjoy that at all. Sweaty yellow undies. Our energy was low.
Yeah, I got hurt somewhere around this place, so she refilled the energy for us.
So, what is one of your favorite words or phrases?
Bite me.
Bite me.
It's just straight to the point. Can't really, you know, confuse it for anything. Just, you're saying what you mean to say. It's concise. It's to the point. It's
bite me.
Not exactly a dirty word, so nobody can get too offended with you. But at the same time, they know you're displeased with you, or you're displeased with them.
Yeah, I always loved some of the insults that you hear in things like Grand Theft Auto, just by, like, the random passerbyers that you might drive by. I don't remember if it was Saints Row or if it was Grand Theft Auto. It had to have been Grand Theft Auto. I cut somebody off in my car, and I heard someone say, "Eat my asshole."
Weird.
What the fuck? What the fuck?
What? We're in Grunty's, I guess, summer home, sort of.
So you have, like, monsters in the paintings?
Oh yeah.
And then the skeleton dude.
Which can only be perma-killed if you go invincible on them.
Just like the mummies.
Exactly.
Do they have, like, a different character similar to that in every area?
No, thankfully they don't.
That's good.
I mean, the last area and this area are pretty much the only real notable areas where they pull that kind of thing on you.
Are they like perma-killed forever?
Yes, hence why I use the phrase perma-killed.
Okay.
Yeah, nice little background touch. If you jump on any of the any fire tiles or sprites or whatever, you get hurt.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, there's been, like, so many games where you can stand in fire and not get hurt.
And there are games like this one where you do get hurt.
Yeah.
Bullcrap.
Oh my gosh. Hey.
Dick.
Dude, dango. Dango.
Do, 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 do.
Help? Is that... That's required? You have to kill him with invincibility?
Mm-hmm. You can't hurt him. You can't touch him otherwise.
Jeez. Are they perma-dead too?
Well, he disappeared in a green puff of smoke, so yes.
Okay.
Generally, if an enemy drops a honeycomb, they're just plain gonzo.
Gotcha. Okay. Ikapoko. Is it purple Jinjo? Is that right? Did I say Jinjo right?
Yes.
Okay.
Hmm.
would you do if you couldn't use the internet or watch TV for a month?
Considering that I work 45, 50 hours a week, sleep.
Yeah, I could see that.
I mean, it's so easy for a lot of the elderly out there to just, I guess there's really no other way I can put this, look down on our generation and say we're a bunch of lazy people, we have things so easy. Oh yeah, we have things so easy when house prices have, what's higher than quadruple? Pentupled?
Quintupled,
thank you. Yeah, when prices have just gone absurdly sky high, and working wages, at least for minimum wage cases, have not really gone up at all. Oh yes, I can definitely see how we're lazy. Whereas a person working two part-time jobs at, say, retail and fast food, respectively, could afford a very decent apartment, or at the very least a cheap home, is absolutely a laughable concept in today's day and age market, because that shit just ain't happening.
Did you...
Real quick, hold on.
Okay.
What? Oh, come on, I thought there was a conversation you had with this guy. Oh, there we go.
Oh my gosh.
You saw the name, right?
Yeah. Glago?
Lago. Lago the toilet. Think about what system they slipped that into here.
Oh, boy.
So, I'm sorry. What were you, saying there before I kind of interrupted you for toilet humor?
Yeah. So, what do you think about, I've heard, and this has been, like, I don't know if this is still in discussion or not. There's McDonald's out there that want to start people at $15 an hour.
Good. Again, please go on and tell me just how much money McDonald's as an entire company makes every single flipping year. I mean, yes, I know you don't have the number in front of you or anything, but
yeah.
the point just kind of remains the same here. Shit. Oh, well. Easy enough to just climb right back up that horse.
It's weird, though. I mean, there's so many conversations or just things that pop up that anger people when they hear that, though.
Do these people who get angry about these things have anything to do with this sort of thing? Does it impact them in any way, shape, or form? Or are they just bitching and moaning because it's the age of the internet and people bitch and moan about whatever the hell they want to bitch and moan about?
Consider this. You've spent the last 10 years, I'm not speaking factually, I'm just saying, you've spent like the last 10 years working the same job so that you can go and get paid $15 an hour. So that you can work as hard as, I mean, and you've been working as hard as you can.
As somebody who has worked at a retail position, not by choice, trust me,
right,
for oh so long, and then to just get told, well, the people who start working here now will receive a higher wage. You're fucked, though. You're staying at the same wage you're at. I mean, seniority and, you know, effort put towards the job mean absolutely zilch.
Exactly.
Now, look, there are pros and cons to everything. But starting people off at higher wages in the first place, I think, is most definitely a step in the right direction.
But now, if people are making more money...
Now, here's the deal with this guy. I can't touch the floor. The floor is essentially lava. Lava that wakes this guy up. There's supposed to be a Mambo token in there.
I see it.
Oh, that's... weird, I don't remember that being there.
Ikaboka. Can you go on the table?
Oh, absolutely.
Okay.
That doesn't rhyme, Grunty.
It's very interesting. I guess I thought that was going to be harder than it was.
Well, if you came through the front door, which I could have, you'd hit the floor and the guy would wake up and solidify and make it impossible to get that jigsaw piece. And then you just start looking there and wondering, okay, how am I supposed to get that? And then you start exploring the upper floor of the house and go, oh, okay, that's
so that, how. The trophy that's spinning around up there?
That's a free life.
Okay, that looks like a trophy of TJ Combo or Fulgore from Killer Instinct.
No, it's just basically Banjo flexing.
Banjo flexing.
I mean, if I were to ever get an opportunity to get a close-up on one, I could show you what I mean, but...
Yeah.
Let's see. I think I've gone in every room that I can actually do things in right now.
So all that's left is to just explore the outside?
Yes, the other 3/4 of this level, yes.
All right, well, we will continue to explore... Ooh,
fuck you.
The other 3/4 of this area on the next episode of We Pway.
And fuck you.
Yeah. Not you guys, just the skeleton. We love you. You're so cool.
Well, that or I'm doing my impression of reality from South Park. One of the two.